Hello and welcome. Here's a step-by-step series for setting up Vaultwarden, formerly known as bitwarden_rs, on a Raspberry Pi. Step 1. Update the Raspberry Pi. Before installing any software, it is always a good idea to update the Raspberry Pi to the latest version. Open a terminal window and run the following command, and install some prepare prerequisites packages. Step 2. Install Rust. Vaultwarden is written in Rust, so you will need to install the Rust programming language on your Raspberry Pi. Run the following command to install Rust. Follow the on-screen instructions to complete the installation. Step 3. Install dependencies. Vaultwarden requires several dependencies to be installed. Run the following command to install them. Step 4. Clone Git repo and move to the Vaultwarden folder. Clone the Vaultwarden repository by running the following command. Move into the clone directory. Step 5. Compile Vaultwarden. For Raspberry Pi with less than 4 GB RAM, add to your system swap partition for compiling. And then get Rust packages for compiling. Then add ARMv8 to the target device. Compile Vaultwarden using the following command. Test first. Then final compile. Step 6. Add service user and group for Vaultwarden. Then create the required folders. Step 7. Download Web Vault. Get Web Vault part for Vaultwarden from GitHub. Check latest version from GitHub. Step 8. Configure Vaultwarden. Create admin token with openslrand command. Edit the configuration file to your liking. You can use the default settings, but you will need to change the domain variable to match the domain name or IP address of your Raspberry Pi. Save and close the file. Step 9. Set permissions. Set proper owner and permissions for Vaultwarden files. Step 10. Create service for Vaultwarden. To run Vaultwarden as a daemon, you can use a process manager like systemd. First, create a systemd service file by running the following command. Add the following content to the service file. Save and close the file. Step 11. Start the Vaultwarden service. Then enable the service and start it. That's it. Your Raspberry Pi should now be running Vaultwarden, and you can access it by navigating to the domain name or IP address you specified in the configuration file in your web browser. Notice that certificate is required to enter via browser master password. Next time, set up a reverse proxy nginx for Vaultwarden with self-signed certificates. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.